Hey guys, Spirit of the Law here. Welcome to a long overdue redo of my overview of the Huns. Now, Huns are maybe best known for their cheap cavalry archers, and certainly that's the unit I championed in the last overview 5 years ago, but the more time goes on, the more I've started to appreciate what a flexible civilization they are in other ways as well. They're consistently a top 5 1v1 civilization by win rate and above average on team games, all with just a handful of straightforward bonuses. A little known fact is that for years this was the only civilization playable on Voobly, and yet nobody even noticed, back in the days of endless Hun Wars. In this video, we're going to be looking at their bonuses, unique unit, and their tech tree to see how it all fits together. Let's check them out. To start with their team bonus, the Huns and all of their allies have 20% faster working stables. That improves both unit production and research times, in case you're wondering. Now, 20% may not seem like a lot compared to the Franks' 40% faster stables unique tech, or the Cumans' 100% faster creation time for scouts and step lancers, but the Huns' bonus can be more significant than it sounds. Creating 6 units in the same time as another civilization makes 5, you can see if we have them fight, the Huns end with close to half their strength remaining. Especially in the early game, having a couple of extra units matters, which is what this bonus can give you. The fact it applies to technologies also saves you 8 seconds on bloodlines and 45 seconds on cavalier and paladin research, helping you jump ahead on the tech curve in early Imperial. The best part is even if you don't go for stable units, in a team game at least one player probably will, so whether it's direct or indirect, you're almost guaranteed to benefit from it. Moving on to their civ bonuses, the first is that they don't need to build houses, but as a trade-off they start with 100 instead of 200 wood. Right away, not needing houses makes them a favorite for new players, though some people also argue it can lead to bad habits if you switch to another civilization later. But how good is this bonus? Houses cost 25 wood and take 25 seconds of build time, so a house essentially costs 33 resources when you put it all together. In Dark Age, you'll typically make 4 or 5 houses, so after the initial minus 100 wood, you're only coming out 30 to 70 resources ahead. Compare that to the Japanese, for example, who come out of Dark Age with usually 200 wood saved already. It does start to add up in Feudal Age though, and by 60 population, you'll have potentially saved around 300 wood, plus building time. There's also the matter of convenience. Getting housed means you have to get loom or wheelbarrow at an unintended time, as well as halting any military unit production. It's easy to fall a villager behind each time you're housed as well, on top of just losing your train of thought. These are all additional benefits on top of the direct wood saved, which on its own can already add up to over 1,000 resources over the course of a game. Now there is a bit of a downside in that you miss out on being able to wall with houses. Houses have triple the HP of palisades in Feudal Age and are often included in walls or added as reinforcement behind them over time. Palisade walls have also been nerfed through updates from 5 to 6 and now 7 seconds of villager time per segment, which disproportionately impacts the Huns given they have to wall not just the normal amount but also the amount that could have been filled by houses. It's one of several reasons that Huns are so much better suited for an aggressive playstyle than walling and booming. Their next bonus is that their cavalry archers cost 10% less in castle and 20% less in Imperial Age. This bonus used to be minus 25% and 30% respectively back in the day, and at first glance it's considerably weaker than it was in Age of Conquerors, but before you go on a rant about inflation, remember the gold cost for cavalry archers has also been brought down since then. The way the numbers work out, their gold cost is basically the same as it used to be, and it's just their wood cost that's higher now. It's still a significant discount though, and considering Huns have fully upgraded cavalry archers in Castle Age, there's really no downside. If we look at Imperial Age though, their heavy cavalry archers lack the final armor upgrade, so in the late game, it's one of those quality versus quantity trade-offs. The trade-off does appear to be worth it though, and with equal resources against generic fully upgraded heavy cavalry archers, Huns still win, but with equal numbers they're of course going to perform worse than many other cavalry archers. Now cavalry archers aren't an especially popular unit in general, but for Huns they're actually a good choice. Part of what makes them so unpopular is they need a lot of upgrades, so a straight fast castle into cavalry archers is often fairly weak. It's better to start with a different unit at the stable or archery range and then make the switch to cavalry archers later. The fact that cavalry archers share so many technologies with both the archer line and scouts or knights means that by getting upgrades for any of those units, you're indirectly setting yourself up for cavalry archers later. It's just a side note to clarify for new players, cavalry archers are affected by archer armor upgrades at the blacksmith and not the cavalry armor upgrades, which might not be totally intuitive. Their last bonus is that their trebuchets have 30% more accuracy, at least officially. More technically, it's plus 35%, but even that's not really accurate to say. Normally, trebuchets have perfect accuracy 15% of the time, though their missed shots will occasionally hit anyway, especially against units as large as enemy trebuchets. In theory, this bonus adds 35%, but in practice, after testing over 2,400 shots between trebuchets at their maximum range, I found it moves them from the low 30s to just under 60% accuracy against enemy trebuchets. Since trebuchets take 3 hits to bring down, we'd expect Huns to win after 5 shots on average, while a generic civilization would need 9 or 10. Again, that's just on average, and there is a chance the enemy trebuchet could get lucky and beat the Huns. For example, in 1,000 trials at maximum range, Huns beat a generic civilization in a treb war 82% of the time, with the generic trebuchet winning 11%. On the other hand, they don't have siege engineers, and all trebuchets are 100% accurate against buildings as large as castles, so this is primarily an anti-trebuchet bonus. Technically, Britons are even better against units with 100% accuracy, but that only comes after a very expensive unique tech. So those are the Huns bonuses, and next we'll take a look at their unique unit, the Tarkin. I've looked at them in depth recently as its own topic and broke down some specific matchups, but to give a quick overview here, compared to the Nightline, the Tarkin is a lower attack, lower melee armor, but higher pierce armor version. Immediately that implies it should do significantly worse in melee combat, which would be a good takeaway as it's what I found, even when its lower gold cost is taken into account. In addition to a lower gold cost, Tarkins are cheaper and faster to upgrade in Imperial Age, but in melee fights at least, you're only getting something roughly comparable to a Cavalier. The main takeaway is that while Tarkins might feel like a cheaper alternative to the Nightline, in the vast majority of melee situations, they end up underperforming. Tarkins do take more arrows than their Nightline counterparts thanks to extra pierce armor, but considering their lower attack, I think of them more as a damage sponge than a truly anti-archer specialist like the Huscarl. The most obvious use for Tarkins is actually against buildings. Tarkins have a large bonus against them, especially walls and gates, so they're useful for breaking through defenses and sniping town centers. As an example, 8 Tarkins in Castle Age can bring down a town center, whereas 8 knights can't. Generally though, I think it's better to stick with the knight line as Huns, given how much worse Tarkins perform in melee combat. Tarkins are more of a situational anti-building and sort of anti-archer unit. Now, one always-present weakness of unique units is that they're created at a castle, which is more expensive than other military buildings, so it's usually hard to mass them up. For Tarkins though, that specific issue is addressed by their Castle Age unique tech, letting them be trained at stables. It's not quite as amazing as it sounds though, as they secretly take a little over 50% longer to train at stables even after the Huns team bonus. Huns already have strong gold units like knights, cavalry archers, and rams or trebuchets, so you don't need to make Tarkins generally. But if you do decide to go mass Tarkin against either an archer civilization or to raid important buildings, this tech at least addresses their dependency on castles. Their other unique tech is Atheism. This is a bit of a strange one with almost no impact on games with Conquest Victory. Maybe the original developers thought that Standard Victory would be the standard, but that's not the case. Conquest Victory is the standard, except in Definitive Edition's Quick Play for some reason. Now, the Atheism tech has a few different effects, and the first is that it adds 100 years to Wonder and Relic victories. Unfortunately, it also adds 100 years to your own victories, so it's easy to think of situations where it might end up hurting you to research it. 100 years in Age of Empires, by the way, is equivalent to 8 minutes and 20 seconds of in-game time, so it extends the countdown from roughly 10 to 15 minutes of real time. It also reduces the cost of spies from 200 to 100 gold per enemy villager. I've seen spies researched in free-for-all games or where a particularly stubborn player refuses to resign, so in rare cases it might come in handy. The cost of treason is also cut in half, which is useful in regicide games where it reveals the location of enemy kings, and again that might situationally help. Especially when combined with the Tarkin's anti-building bonus, it makes Huns a decent pick on regicide. Overall though, this has to be one of the least useful unique techs, which is actually fine given Huns are already a top 5 civilization. They don't really need anything extra from their unique techs, and in the majority of games, Hun players end up not researching either of them. But now let's move on and take a look at their other options in the tech tree, starting with the archers. In the early and mid-game, you have everything available, though notice the missing final armor upgrade, lack of arbalest, and hand cannoneer. It might seem like the crossbow line is a bad idea because it can't be upgraded in Imperial, but I actually think archers into crossbows is a good strategy for Huns. That said, you do want to transition to cavalry archers during Castle Age as your primary range support unit. The lack of an armor upgrade isn't ideal, but with Parthian tactics and the cavalry archer discount, I think Huns end up with at least one good ranged option at every stage of the game. Next, for their infantry, they're missing champion and plate mail armor, along with supplies and the Eagle Warrior line, of course. Basically, you don't really want to use the barracks if you don't have to. The pike line is still a valid option as a counter unit, and in a serious pinch, you might use two-handed swordsmen against eagles. I'd say it's a C+ for infantry, and not something used outside of militia, defensive spearmen, and the odd counter unit. Moving on now to cavalry, this is always a good option as Huns. The faster working stables is great for opening scouts, or even in a fast castle into knights. For me, they're an A, but not an A+, as there's a couple of civilizations I think do have an edge over them, especially in the late game. Jumping over to their siege, they actually have the least amount of variety at the siege workshop of any civilization, and notably are one of only two civs without onager. That said, the siege ram is a great complement to cavalry archers who have trouble against buildings, and don't forget the more accurate trebuchets. You might make a few mangonels in Castle Age, but late game it's really all about rams and trebs. I'd say it's a B- for siege, because while there are some very obvious gaps here, in practice you actually have what you need most of the time. Next up, we have the navy. Like I said earlier, the lack of needing houses isn't an amazing bonus in Dark Age, but the savings start to really add up in Feudal. There's no specific water bonus here, but based on economy alone, I feel like they're an A- early on. Late game, you're missing out on a lot of important techs, so you'd be relying mostly on the galleon instead of fire ships, and I'd say it's a B- in the late game for an overall B+. Taking a quick look now at the monks, right away, lacking redemption removes their usefulness against siege and buildings. Block printing is also a good one to have in the late game, along with theocracy for converting units as a group. It's not a complete disaster, but comparable to Goths and Franks, who each got a C, and that feels about right here. Aside from the basics of collecting relics and converting expensive units, there's no reason for Huns to invest heavily in monks. Looking now at defenses, you really see how much Huns are pushed toward being aggressive. The only university techs they get are the ones that basically every civilization has, plus masonry, which only a couple miss out on. Unlike Goths, Huns do at least have stone walls though, so I'll give them a pass with a C-. As for their economy, you actually have a good variety of techs, with crop rotation and stone shaft mining being the only things missing. They aren't the most important techs though, and between their free houses and cavalry archer discount, Huns end up with a fairly strong economy. I'd say it's an A-. I'm also going to include a section here about trash units, as I think that's worth showing at a glance. Trash units of course refers to skirmishers, halberdiers, and hussars, since they don't cost any gold. The Huns are missing a couple of late game armor techs, but they have an otherwise decent variety. I wouldn't say they're a great trash unit civ, but they're not that bad either, so I'd give them a solid B. So that's the Huns tech tree and where I see their strengths and weaknesses. As a rough game plan, their bonuses work really well in the early game with either scouts or archers. Either way, it helps lead you to your discounted cavalry archers, but you can still play Huns just as well as a scout into knight civilization. Despite a restrictive tech tree in Imperial Age, you have a great variety of units in Castle Age to choose from, and I think that's when they peak. To me, the Huns' strength is how easily they can jump from stable units, which are countered by spears and pikes, over to archery range units that handle spears fairly easily. If you then see a lot of skirmishers, you can jump back over to cavalry. Huns are about playing aggressively and making use of the fact you have two great military buildings that can play off one another. Their toughest matchup then should be against camel civilizations, and looking at their worst 1v1 matchups does seem to confirm that. Huns also fall off a bit in particularly long games as they lose some of their flexibility and the effects of some of their bonuses wear off. Playing aggressively is what's rewarded as Huns, which makes them so fun to play, but can also feel like it puts you on a clock to close the game relatively early. It might be why Huns tend to have some of the shortest games of any civilization as well. So that's an overview of the Huns. Hopefully it gives you some ideas to try, whether you're playing with or against them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.